Kawempe North Member of Parliament, Honorable Mohamed Seguirinha, has been accused by his opponent of playing ping-pong games in the petition that is challenging his election. It's understood the case came up today, and the Electoral Commission lawyer Edwin Tabaro said that Seguirinha was never notified by Kidandala's lawyers of the petition against him, as he was in prison in Kitalia, where he was remanded over unlawful assembly. Let's also take a look at some of the other petitions that are being filed by the various members of parliament against various members of parliament across the country.
Sulaiman Kidandala, who came second in the Kawempe North January polls with 7,512 votes, dragged Mohamed Seguirinha, who won the seat with 41,197 votes, to court for lack of prerequisite academic qualifications. Kidandala also sued the Electoral Commission for allowing Seguirinha to be nominated when he is not a registered voter of Kawempe North or any other area in Uganda.
I wrote that as a matter of the petition. My brother is the petition of the president.
Today, when the case came up, Electoral Commission lawyer Edwin Tabaro revealed that Seguirinha had never been notified by Kidandala's lawyers of the petition against him since he was in prison in Kitalia, where he was remanded over unlawful assembly. Tabaro told court that there is no evidence to show that Seguirinha was served personally or through the officer in charge of Kitalia prisons, as the law says.
That all counsel submit amongst ourselves the list of witnesses that we intend for. There is. And then they will be
However, Kidandala's lawyers, led by Kenneth Paul Kakande, said Seguirinha was playing ping-pong games to escape the petition. The lawyers insisted that it is appalling that, having been served through the officer in charge of Kitalia prison, Seguirinha is still denied.
I advise that if you cannot find the respondent, you go to court and apply for substitute service. It is called substitute service. Then the court gives you an order how you are going to serve. We made that application, and court gave us two orders: pin the notes of presentation on the notes board, and that was done by the registrar of court. Secondly, go and serve the petitioner, I mean the respondent, in Kitalia prison, since that is where he was incarcerated. And we sent a process server to Kitalia.
The lawyer also told court that they had used the second option when they were allowed to serve Seguirinha the petition challenging his election through the notice board. He further revealed that Seguirinha is processing a visa to Germany under the guise of sickness, so that when he is wanted by court, he is not around.
As far as the Electoral Commission is concerned, we served in the Electoral Commission. But they are saying we did not serve the first respondent. We are also aware that the first respondent is now processing visa to run out of the country to go to Germany, feigning sickness, so that if court makes another order of service, he's not in the country. But we also know that the petition and the notes of presentation are pinned on the notes board of court, and the first respondent is no longer in court, in prison. There is no way he can say he's still in prison. Because he would have made that argument that I'm still in prison, there's no way I can see court. But he goes on radio and TV, say I was not served. He knows there is a petition. Those are the issues the court is going to determine. There is an application to strike out the petition, which is going to come next week on Thursday to address the issue of service. We are sure we served. We served this petition.
So many forces in this petition. The petition has touched every arm of government. The petition has touched society, and everyone is under test. Education bodies are under test. If we are going to convince the general public that work so hard to take your kids to school, to to attain some degree of education, and others can short circuit, can find shortcuts to such a process and even attain positions of leadership to that level, my friend, you are simply killing your own.
The court has, however, set September 2nd, 2021 as the date to hear the application in which the Electoral Commission asked the electoral petition against Segirinya be dismissed for not being served. In its argument, the Electoral Commission says there is no evidence to show that Chidandila's lawyers served Segirinya with a copy of the petition challenging his election since he was in prison by the time the petition was filed. Speaking to journalist EC lawyer Tabairo said Chidandila's petition does not stand if the first respondent, Segirinya, was not served with the same.
In this particular case, the OC was instructed by the court order to receive. Unfortunately, they did not serve him, and he has sworn affidavit saying he did not receive the petition. So as we stand now, and as we know it, there is no petition against the member of parliament. Until that is determined, then we cannot talk of the petition. So the application has been fixed for 2nd of September for the judge to rule on that technicality. Then the people of Koempendo and the parties in this case can be able to know whether there's such a matter. Otherwise, what we are doing and what we are exercising is the role of EC in handling disputes. They organize cases, they organize elections, but they also handle the disputes arising out of the petition, and the procedure is very clear.
Like previous proceedings, Segirinya again was not present in today's proceedings at court. In Iganga, High Court has adjourned parliamentary election petition for Bokoli South Constituency Namayengo District to Friday next week. The case was filed by former area MP Stephen Mayende Dede against MP Abudu Adida, whom he accuses of allegedly using academic papers for another person during nominations. The case is being heard by Judge Godfrey Namundi, a senior resident judge from Bale High Court. However, today's session was not hard in an open court, but rather in the judge's office in the presence of only two lawyers from both parties. Some of the supporters and relatives of both sides and media who had turned up eager to follow the proceedings were left puzzled in court chambers and premises. After the session, the petitioner's lawyers, led by Moses Kiza, told the waiting journalists that they had adjourned the case to Friday next week on their request to allow them file more evidence in the case. Story by Rachel Nachuala and Ivan Wachibi for the news.